Losing weight and boosting your immune system do not have to be separate goals. Like the tide that lifts all boats, practicing good diet and lifestyle habits will get you healthy from the inside out. Here are five things that you can do to gain health and lose weight at the same time. You've probably heard it said that if you want to ward off illness, you should eat a rainbow every day, which is a catchy way of reminding us to eat a variety of colorful fruits and vegetables. But what we are really being told to do is eat our antioxidants. That's because colorful plant foods are rich in cell-protecting substances called antioxidants. They are most prevalent in plants because plants make them as a natural protection against UV light from the sun and other environmental stressors. And when you eat the plants, the antioxidants are transferred to you and provide you with a similar type of protection. Antioxidants defend your cells against free radicals, which are unstable molecules that can damage your cells, including your cells' DNA, which is what can lead to a weakened immune system. So eating a rainbow of colorful fruits and vegetables will support your immune system, but those foods contain carbs. If you are following a low-carb or keto diet, you need to be selective in your food choices. As for fruits, berries are a good choice because they are relatively low in carbs, yet they have very rich, deep colors, which indicates that they are rich in antioxidants. When it comes to vegetables, you want to focus on non-starchy vegetables with vibrant colors. So dark leafy greens are more nutritious than pale iceberg lettuce, and different colored peppers will provide your body with a variety of different antioxidants. And I have a video on 17 low-carb vegetables that will provide you with more choices if you would like to watch that. I'll point to it. Now, I will say that even though free radicals are looked at as bad apples, we do need some of them in our bodies. And in fact, they can be used by our immune cells to help destroy bacteria. The problem is that we tend to do things that create too many free radicals, and that's when the damage occurs and we open ourselves up to illness. Just like plants, environmental stressors are problems for us. So things like too much sun exposure, smoking, and a poor diet that contains a lot of refined and processed foods are what lead to damage. So your immune system and your weight do best when you ditch the empty calories. Whole foods that have been minimally processed contain both macro and micronutrients. Macronutrients are what we get the vast majority of our calories from, so those are the carbs, fats, and proteins in our foods. Micronutrients are the non-caloric vitamins and minerals in our foods. When a food is processed and refined, the micronutrients are lost, and this is when we say that the food is nothing more than empty calories. So examples of these would be soda, refined bread, and the three C's, cookies, cakes, and candies. And these foods are obviously bad for your waistline, and you can probably guess that their lack of micronutrients make them rather useless for your health as well. But beyond that, these junk foods often contain chemical preservatives and flavorings that your body must break down and eliminate, which requires resources that could otherwise be used for repair and protection. So just keep in mind that whether the food comes from a plant or an animal, you always are better off eating foods that still resemble their source. So a salmon fillet is going to be better than a fish stick, and a whole vegetable is going to be better than veggie chips. Now, when life gets busy and stressful, sleep is one of the first things that suffers. And while we all know that sleep is important, most of us overlook how much it affects our weight and our immune system. Being sleep deprived changes your hunger hormones and boosts your cravings for junk food. You have two main hunger hormones. They are leptin and ghrelin. Leptin suppresses your appetite and ghrelin stimulates it. When you lack adequate sleep, leptin goes down and ghrelin goes up, leaving you feeling hungrier than usual throughout the day. And on top of that, the hunger you feel when you are sleep deprived is less inhibited, which makes it more likely that you will go for the impulsive pizza delivery rather than the home-cooked meal. As for your immune system, sleep deprivation weakens your defenses against illness, and noticeable changes can happen after just one night of disturbed sleep. A study subjected 46 healthy men to a single night of partial sleep deprivation by keeping them awake until 3 a.m. they found that even this modest disturbance of sleep produced a reduction of natural immune responses and white blood cell function. And while no one has nailed down exactly how much sleep we need per night, the general consensus is that we do best when we get between 7 to 9 hours a night. There are some natural supplements that can improve sleep, like melatonin, valerian root, and magnesium. It's also a good practice to go to bed and wake up about the same time every day, even on the weekends. And you also want to help your body wind down in the evenings by avoiding food 3 hours before bedtime. By setting this 3-hour rule, you avoid empty calories from after-dinner drinks and snacks, and you give your body time to complete digestion of your last meal, which allows your core temperature to drop so that you can drop into a deep sleep. This 3-hour rule also serves as the start of a fast, which leads to our next strategy, which is intermittent fasting. Intermittent fasting is a powerful tool for weight loss, and I have many videos here on YouTube that explain why. But it's also a powerful tool for better health, especially if you start your fast early in the evening. A large study on women found that for each 10% increase in the calories they ate after 5 p.m., there was a resulting 3% increase in inflammation. Now, acute inflammation is actually part of your immune system's response to injury and infections, but chronic inflammation that results from a poor diet and lifestyle factors is a burden on your immune system and depletes resources that you need to fight off illness. If you have never tried intermittent fasting before, it is worthwhile, and you can start with a simple 12-hour fast. So to do this, you can just stop eating after dinner and then delay breakfast for 12 hours, until 12 hours have passed. When you feel comfortable at that level, you can work up to 14 to 16 hours of fasting. Fasting and eating healthy will also improve your gut health, which is vital for weight loss and immunity. A healthy gut is one that contains an abundant and diverse community of bacteria. And while we don't typically think of our digestive tract and immune system as being linked, the surprising fact is that about 75% of your body's immune cells are found in your gut. As for how the gut impacts your weight, a study looked at pairs of female twins in which one of the twins was overweight and the other was not. They found that the overweight twin had a lower diversity of bacteria in her gut than her sibling. The bacteria of the gut feed off of remnants of undigested food. Foods that feed the bacteria include high fiber foods like the colorful fruits and vegetables that I mentioned at the beginning of the video, as well as fermented foods like yogurt, sauerkraut, and kimchi. And interestingly, not eating may also have a positive effect on your gut. Studies have shown that restricting food intake for periods of the day, just like we would with intermittent fasting, may positively influence the diversity and abundance of gut bacteria. You know, viral and bacterial infections can sneak up on us very quickly. So it is important that you have a strong immune system in place to ward off these invaders. Fortunately, the actions that give you a healthy immune system can also help you lose weight. If you need a place to start, you can download my free 4 Daily Habits for Weight Loss, which will get you started with the strategies we discussed here. I will leave links here on the video and down below. Thanks so much for watching. Please subscribe to my channel and have a great week.